Hey YouTube, Jim here. Welcome to Top 10 Archive. Today we're giving animals yet another opportunity to scare us straight. Lions, tigers, and bears, oh my! Well, not really, since they don't kill many people. You don't have to live in Australia or Africa to live in constant fear of being around a dangerous animal. Some of these animals may be fascinating, but we should probably admire them from a distance if we can. Here are the top 10 most dangerous animals in the world. And before we get started, we'd like to note that we excluded humans from our list. Had we included ourselves as a species, we'd far outweigh number one on this list through homicide, genocide, war, and famine. Number 10, crocodiles. Like a few animals on this list, certain species within the group are responsible for the vast majority of human deaths. Crocodiles are definitely one of those animals. According to NPS.gov, 23 different species of crocodilians exist, two of which are alligators, the American and Chinese alligator. The Chinese alligator is considered the most docile and is practically extinct, and the American alligator is responsible for 22 deaths since 1948 in the state of Florida. When we talk about the 1,000 or so deaths every year globally, the vast majority of them occur in Africa, and the Nile crocodile is to blame. Since deaths often go unreported in the area, we can only guess how many people actually die, but many studies have landed on around 1,000 people. It's estimated that between one-third and one-half of all crocodile attacks in Africa lead to death. Number 9. Tapeworms. By the numbers, tapeworms aren't endemic to any particular region, but rather tend to pop up in places where food preparation standards aren't up to par. Of the 2,000 or so deaths every year, 30 or so are from the United States. Taenia solium, better known as pork tapeworm, is one of the most common and deadly forms that breed in, you guessed it, undercooked pork. Having one of these worms usually leads to cysticercosis, a parasitic tissue infection that affects the brain, muscle, and other tissues. Number 8. Ascaris roundworms. According to a study by the Global Burden of Disease, or GBD, an estimated 1 billion people are infected and 2,500 people die every year from ascariasis, a disease caused by the parasitic roundworm Ascaris lumbricoides. Sadly, most of those victims are children. More than 85% of those infected show no symptoms and there's no vaccine. But thankfully, with the advent of better hygiene and education in poorer countries, numbers have been steadily decreasing with passing years. Infection occurs by consuming a food or beverage contaminated with Ascaris eggs from feces. The eggs hatch in your intestines, the larvae burrow through the gut wall, and migrate to the lungs via the blood. They then break into the alveoli and pass up the trachea, where they are coughed up and may be swallowed. The larvae then pass through the stomach for a second time into the intestine, where they become adult worms. Gross. Number 7. Scorpions. Despite its overall alien appearance and the fact that I still have nightmares from that scene from Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, the power of some scorpions haven't been respected as they should. That's probably because of the 2,000 known species, only 25 carry enough venom powerful enough to kill a human, which is probably why we compare their stings to a larger wasp or non-lethal spiders. For the 25 species that do carry venom, though, this is farthest from the truth. On average, an estimated 1.2 million people are stung by scorpions annually, and of those, about 3,250 will die. Most deaths occur in Africa, South India, the Middle East, Mexico, and South Latin America. In South America, it's the Brazilian yellow scorpion you have to worry about, which is probably responsible for the most deaths worldwide. If you're living in the Middle East region, keep your distance from the Arabian fat-tailed scorpion, and in Mexico, the bark scorpion is responsible for the most stings and deaths. Number 6. Snails. Although there are over 43,000 known species of snails, categorized by land, sea, and freshwater, it's mainly the freshwater snails that have been an ongoing issue for us humans. Cone snails are also an issue, but we'll get to those later. of the estimated 10,000 to 20,000 deaths associated with freshwater snails annually, the vast majority occur in Asia, Africa, and South America, usually in poorer and underdeveloped countries. The freshwater snail carries parasitic worms that infect people with a disease called schistosomiasis, which can cause intense abdominal pain and blood in the stool or urine, and tends to lead to death when untreated. Cone snails, albeit far more lethal, kill far fewer people because we tend to encounter them less. In the past 90 years, only 36 people have reportedly died from cone snails, so our data and understanding of them are pretty bare. What we do know is that 1 microliter, or about 1 droplet of cone snail toxin, is powerful enough to kill 5 people. And that one unfortunate patient died just 6 hours after being stung. Number 5, assassin bugs. When we talk about assassin bugs, it's more than one species that we're talking about. It's actually several of the blood-sucking species known as triatomine bugs. And when we're talking about the bugs killing people, which happen to be about 10,000 people annually worldwide, it's actually Chagas disease doing the dirty work. The bugs mainly live in North, Central, and South America, so for those of you who live everywhere else, consider yourself lucky. Chagas disease is a horrible one, and not just because it will eventually kill you, but because 70% of victims will be symptom-free until the disease basically kills them, which is usually by attacking the heart and nervous system. Number 4, tsetse fly. Even though the tsetse fly is at least 34 million years old, we as humans still haven't figured out a way to keep them from killing us. Roughly 10,000 people, in fact, will die worldwide each year, mainly caused by diseases that the bug carries. The fly carries all sorts of diseases that transmit to a very large selection of hosts. But in humans in particular, it's the parasite Trypanosoma brucei, which causes the chronic disease sleeping sickness that's killing everyone, mostly in Western and Eastern Africa. On a positive note, the number of cases seems to continuously go down year after year as modern medicine becomes more readily available in hotspots of Africa. Number 3, dogs. We know. As dog lovers ourselves, it's hard to think our most lovable companions are third on this list. There are many layers here, so hear us out. First, dogs are said to kill roughly 35,000 people worldwide every year, but only about 30 of those are in the United States. How can the U.S. make up 1/20th of the world population, but 1/1,000th of dog-related deaths? Almost all dog-related deaths in the United States and other developed countries are from maulings, which you have a 65% chance of it being a pit bull. Whereas in underdeveloped countries, the majority of deaths are caused by rabies. India tops the list, accounting for roughly 60% of all dog-related deaths. Because of India's rampant issue with stray dogs and rabies, more than 20,000 people die each year in the region. Number 2, snakes.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes?
We all knew snakes would be on this list, but at number 2? Well, it kind of makes sense once you think about it. First, there are more than 3,000 known species of snakes on the planet, and you can find them everywhere except Antarctica, Iceland, Ireland, Greenland, and New Zealand. And about 600 species, or 1/5 of all snakes, are venomous. Antivenom is becoming more scarce, and getting it to the victim in time is crucial. And that's wherein the problem lies. An estimated 100,000 people die annually, and another 450,000 suffer life-changing injuries and amputations. All sorts of different snake species are to blame, even non-venomous ones, and the vast majority of deaths occur in Africa, Asia, Latin America, and India, where snakes are prevalent. But antivenom is not. Even when antivenom is available, in some countries, a vial can cost a poor farmer 6 months' salary. Number 1, mosquitoes. We've all been bit by a mosquito once or twice, right? The pesky little bugs suck blood. Blood.
I do not say blah, blah, blah.
And transmit viruses from person to person. and are responsible for the most human-related deaths. With between 750,000 to 1 million deaths claimed annually, mosquitoes are the only animal on the planet that comes close to dethroning humans as our own greatest enemy. Malaria, by itself, is responsible for more than half of mosquito-related deaths, mostly in sub-Saharan Africa. Thankfully, though, it's been a steady decline with each passing year. Malaria cases fell by 37% between 2000 and 2015, according to the World Health Organization. Though lots of progress has been made, we still have a long way to go before we can reclassify mosquitoes as non-threatening. Thanks for watching. So, have you had any personal encounters with any of these animals that was life-threatening? Thankfully, you're still here to tell us about them in the comments. If you've been bitten by the Top 10 Archive bug, no worries. It's perfectly safe to become a subscriber by clicking that button right there, along with ringing the notifications bell and giving this video a thumbs up.